Hi, in this video I want to share a recipe for a relatively high temperature insulation material. I have developed it specially as a replacement for a ceramic hot plate heating element. Main differences are that it is cast double, it has lower mechanical strength and slightly higher thermal conductivity. The main feature is that it is made out of commonly available materials. Most high-tech material that I have used was glass fiber. And finally, temperature resistance seems to be about 800 degrees Celsius. Okay, enough stats, now let's look at the process. To make this thing you will need sodium silicate, hydrochloric acid, glass fiber and plaster. If I say gypsum I mean plaster, I mean, isn't it the same thing? Do I know? Yeah, I forgot to mention you will also need water. I will leave proportions of ingredients down in the description. Okay, so first step, make silica gel. So for this batch I started by pouring 700 ml of water into beaker. Then I measure as precisely as possible 46.7 grams of sodium silicate in plastic cup. And mix sodium silicate with about half of the water that you have in the beaker. Then in another plastic cup measure even more precisely 14.000000 grams of hydrochloric acid. My point is that you cannot overshoot hydrochloric acid because you will not get silica gel. And pour remaining water from the beaker to the plastic cup with hydrochloric acid. Now grab both cups and pour them simultaneously back into the beaker. After some time, depending on the ratio that you got, the solution will start to get cloudy. I always try to get as neutral solution as possible. With small excess of sodium silicate, the solution will turn into the gel very quickly. But I'm not sure if it has any effect of resulting material, I guess not really, but I don't know. Well, my point is that I had to wait about an hour for gel to develop, so that was quite unnecessarily long. But I captured the process on camera and sped it up so you can kinda see how it looks. So when the gel is done, it looks like this. It is gel. In this batch I have decided to add aluminium powder. It did not work at all, I mean it had no effect. But I have to show it anyway because I have to explain somehow why my resulting material is black. So I poured it in this stage. And I must admit this effect is pretty cool. I think I should call this Lung Simulator 2 million. Well anyway, then I added some more aluminium powder and mixed a lot. This at least shows you how important it is to mix this thing very well because it is gel and, well, gels do not mix very well. And in the last step we will add some gypsum and glass fiber. I would recommend using gypsum as quickly setting as possible because it will be extremely diluted and, well, if you leave it sitting there for too long it will settle on the bottom and it will not be good. I am using this cheap disposable aluminium trays for baking stuff. I was pretty much still at testing phase at this point. You can either form some features on it while it's wet, or you can carve it when it's set. I have decided to go for carving this time, but I have experimented with overmolding glass fiber cloth and it works very well. I'm not using any special tools for carving this time, but I have done also some carving with tool that has set depth and it works well too. So here's another heater lining that I have built, it's white this time. But I have decided to test aluminium reflector and to make it non-conductive I placed glass fiber cloth on top of it. And of course this didn't make any difference as well. At least I tried, right? Now finally on top of this I will put this heating wire. And finally measure the performance of the material itself. Now since I went over 666 degrees Celsius, I will leave you here with the images of aluminium plate that I have in there.